Hey everybody! The transfer market is gaining momentum and we have gathered all the latest news from the world of football just for you. Here we go and let's get the show on the pitch! Brazil have beaten Spain 4-2 in the semi-final of the Olympic Women's Football Tournament 2024. In the final, the Seleção will take on the USWNT, who defeated Germany in extra time, 1-0. Juventus had a friendly against Juventus Next Gen. Juve U23 squad and won 4-0. Danilo, Timothy Weah, Kenan Yildiz and Kefren Thuram scored the goals. 32-year-old Argentine goalkeeper Jeronimo Rulli will move from Ajax to Olympique Marseille. It's stated that the clubs have reached a total agreement on the deal. The transfer fee will be over 3 million euros. The climate activist group Futuro Vegetal broke into Messi's 11 million euros mansion in Ibiza and sprayed the white facade of the building with the red and black paint to protest against the rich. Jose Mourinho was a machine. He brings the best out of you. He is manipulative. He knows how to get in your head, how to treat you, regardless of your level. Zlatan Ibrahimovic shared. Bayern Munich are open to letting Coman leave on loan with an obligation to buy him back. PSG are interested in the Kingsley's services. Manchester United have contacted Youssouf Fofana's agents. 2-3 weeks ago, the club presented its project and plans. At this stage, the Red Devils have not yet made a concrete offer to AS Monaco. Hansi Flick is not counting on Vitor Roque in the upcoming season. The striker could go on loan or join another club on a permanent transfer. Sevilla have acquired Luciana Gomez on a permanent deal from Inter Milan. The contract is valid until 2028. According to insider Fabrizio Romano, the transfer fee for the 22-year-old Frenchman will be worth 4 million euros, in addition to a 50% sell-on fee. Bayern Munich winger Brian Zaragoza has decided to switch to Valencia on a loan deal instead of Girona. Defensive midfielder Guido Rodriguez has completed his move to West Ham United. He joined the Hammers as a free agent. I'm sure Mbappe will adjust quickly to Real Madrid, Carlo Ancelotti assured. Centre-back Mats Hummels could retire from professional football. The footballer is considering ending his career, but has not yet made a final decision. Borussia Dortmund midfielder Emre Can will remain the team's captain, according to the club's sporting director Sebastian Kell. Espanyol have recruited Union Berlin central midfielder Alex Kral. The 26-year-old Czech will go to the Catalan club on loan with an option to buy for almost 3 million euros. Barcelona are in talks with La Liga to play some La Liga fixtures in the United States in the 2025-26 campaign. Romania have brought back Mircea Lucescu for a second spell in charge of the national team. The contract is valid until 2026. The Ballon d'Or is not a title I aspire to. There were often world footballers in my team, Cristiano Ronaldo, Luka Modric, Benzema. So I helped them win it, Toni Kroos claimed. Real Betis centre-back Germán Pesella has completed his move to River Plate. According to Transfermarkt, the player will cost the Argentine side 4.5 million euros. Victor Osimhen has turned down Al Hilal and Al Ahly approaches because he wants to stay in Europe, Nicola Schira reports. Fiorentina are closing in on signing Albert Gudmundsson. The club is offering 6 to 7 million for a loan deal, plus an 18 to 19 million euros buyout option. Messi and Ronaldo have been addicted to success throughout their careers. It never stopped. And they decided not to stop at the top, like 95% of all players, but to enjoy football a bit longer. And that's a good path to take, Toni Kroos noted. Rennes have announced the signing of right lateral Hans Hedebor from Atalanta. The transfer fee for the 30-year-old Dutchman totaled 3 million euros. When I was in Brighton, the pressure was less. At Chelsea, it's different, said Moises Caicedo. Lenny Yoro on his foot injury, which could sideline him for 3 months. This is not the start I wanted, but that's football. Sevilla left-back Ludvig Augustinsson has joined Anderlecht. The contract between the parties will last for 3 years. Torino are negotiating the transfer of Union Berlin left-back Robin Gosens, Nicola Schira informs. Guys, it's time to support us with a like and a subscription. Thank you. A lot of interesting matches were played yesterday. Let's have a look at their results. Real Madrid outplayed Chelsea thanks to goals from Vasquez and Brahim, with Madueke scoring for the Blues. In the other top-notch match of the day, Barcelona managed to come back when trailing 0-2. The Catalans responded to goals from Jovic and Pulisic with a brace from Lewandowski. Then, in the penalty shootout, the Rossoneri proved to be a stronger side, 3-4. Alright, moving on to other news of the release. Manchester City forward Julian Alvarez and Chelsea midfielder Conor Gallagher will become Atletico Madrid players, reports insider Fabrizio Romano. It's noted that Los Colchoneros will pay 75 million euros for the 24-year-old Argentine, a fixed amount. Man City could receive another 20 million euros in bonuses. The striker has given the green light to pen a 5-year contract. In fact, the citizen signed him for £14 million, which makes Julian a record sale for the club. The 24-year-old English midfielder will also ink a 5-year contract, with Chelsea receiving 42 million euros for him. Today, the footballer is expected to undergo a medical at the club. Atletico Madrid are keen on recruiting Al Nassr centre-back Emerick Laporte, writes Relevo journalist Matteo Moreto. Madrid giants are looking for a partner for the new team's defender Robin Lehnermann. Therefore, they are considering the possibility of inviting 30-year-old Laporte. You see, David Hansko's transfer from Feyenoord has been stalled, as the clubs cannot decide on the transfer fee. Laporte is willing to take a significant pay cut in order to return to Spain, though Atletico are currently focused on landing a midfielder and a forward. That's why negotiations with Emerick are being postponed. According to Sky Sport journalist Florian Plettenberg, Bayer Leverkusen centre-back Jonathan Tah is close to switching to Bayern Munich. According to the source, the transfer fee for the 28-year-old German will be 25 million euros plus 5 million in bonuses. The footballer's contract with Die Roten will be running for 5 years. Jonathan's move will be completed once the Bundesliga Titans sell their centre-back Matthijs de Ligt to Manchester United. Last season, the defender scored 6 goals and delivered 1 assist in 48 appearances. Atletico Madrid forward Samuel Omorodion is nearing a move to Chelsea, says insider Nicolas Quira. According to the source, the transfer of the 20-year-old Spaniard to the Blues camp is in its final stages. The transfer fee is worth 42 million euros plus 8 million in bonuses. Samuel's contract with the London club will last until the summer of 2030, with an option to extend for a further season. Atletico acquired Omorodion last summer from Granada for 6 million euros and immediately sent him on loan to Deportivo Alaves, where he bagged 9 goals and provided 1 assist in 36 appearances. Athletic Bilbao winger Nico Williams has recorded a video message to his club's fans amid rumors of his potential transfer to Barcelona or PSG. "It's okay, I'm back, and I'm really looking forward to the start of this season. Vamos, Athletic," Williams stated. Us understands this as a confirmation of Nico's intention to stay with his current team. However, according to the latest info, Blaugrana are still not giving up and they will try to convince the player. RB Leipzig attacking midfielder Dani Olmo will pursue his career at Barcelona, claims insider Fabrizio Romano. As it was reported by the source, yesterday on the 6th of August, the parties have reached a verbal agreement regarding the Spaniard's transfer after a meeting between RB Leipzig representatives, Olmo's agent, and Barca sporting director Deco. The transfer fee is worth 55 million euros plus 7 million in bonuses. Olmo will pen a 6-year contract with the Catalans. Moreover, he has already arrived in Barcelona to undergo a medical ahead of signing the contract and completing the move. Folks, Hansi is building something incredible at Barcelona, and you have to see it. Be sure to click on the video below and have a great time watching.